Once enlarged, cavities are rarely used by red cockaded. In a typical colony, some cavities are under construction, some are active, and some are abandoned. A family group or clan consists of a breeding pair and sometimes one or more helpers, typically young males that don't leave home. In this social system, 2 to 7 of the birds live together in clusters of cavity trees, colonies, within an area of 10 to 20 acres in the forest, where they defend territory and communally raise young. When young females and some of the males go forth to seek unmated birds, they prefer not to travel far, usually only a couple of miles. Red-cockaded woodpeckers are territorial, highly allegiant to place. They do not migrate. Mating birds bond for life until one of the pair dies. And for such petite birds, they're long-lived, often surviving for 8 years or more. The birds roost one to a cavity at night. If holes are in short supply, they will roost in scars in pine trees, cavities between limbs, or in holes in dead trees. Red-cockaded woodpeckers are sociable and gossip with clan members a spell before beginning the day's harvest of roaches, ants, butterfly larvae, and spiders, found by scaling bark and digging into limbs. Food supply on pines is limited, so a clan requires a foraging territory of 100 to 1,000 acres, depending on the quality of habitat. On occasion, they eat black gum or wild cherry fruit, or even enter fields to devour corn earworms. Clans forced into smaller foraging areas have difficulty raising young. As ornithologist Todd Engstrom puts it, red-cockaded woodpeckers have 3 levels of need: tree, for roosting and nesting; forest, for foraging; and landscape, for exchange of clan members. Smaller clans farther apart make it difficult for single woodpeckers to find mates. When one member of a group dies, an individual from a nearby group can fill the gap, maintaining social structures. For this reason, red-cockaded woodpecker researchers recommend protecting longleaf on the level of landscape.